So this is the version of the packet tracer software that I am using. If you want to do anything related to the Internet of Things IoT, you must download this version itself. It is version 7.2.0. You are already from the electronics department, so a lot of things that you are going to see here, it might be familiar to you as well. So this version 7.2.0 that we have, I think like they have the latest version as 7.3. You can download that as well if you want, completely up to you. But when we talk about this packet tracer software, it still has traditional router switches. It still has that traditional router switches. We have these hubs. We have these different types of wireless devices as well. So this still has those traditional device supports as well, firewall and other things. But apart from those things, this packet tracer software, this new version of this packet tracer software also comes with some other things. We have our end devices as well. If you go, let me just try to zoom in a little bit. Okay. Okay. So if you go there, you will see that here we have different network devices, switches, hubs, wireless devices. I hope you can see this. Different wireless devices are there. You know, different types of Meraki access point. We have different types of devices there actually. WLC, wireless LAN controller, different devices are there. Now, this in wireless section, this is one device that we have that is something called home gateway. This home gateway looks something like this. If you talk about the physical structure, this is how a home gateway looks like. It is more like a device that we are going to use in our lab for interaction between different types of IoT based devices. This is a home gateway device. You know, typically a Wi-Fi router can act as this home gateway device. It has one internet port, some Ethernet ports are there. So this is one of the home gateway device that we see. We'll be using that later on. Forget about it as of now. Other than that, if you go, there are some security based devices. You go there. In the end device section, you have your general end devices like PC, laptop, server. You have all these general end devices as well. But if you go to the home section, in the home section, you will be able to identify that we have variety of home environment devices as well. Home appliance like coffee machine, some sort of battery, some sort of Bluetooth speaker, some sort of carbon dioxide detector, some sort of carbon monoxide detector. These fan, ceiling fan, small door, garage, home speaker, for example, humidifier, so humidity monitor, home appliances are there that we are going to use in our IoT environment. Just wait. We have different type of, you know, lawn sprinkler, for example. As soon as it is 3 p.m., lawn sprinkler should sprink some sort of water in the lawn. So those things are there. Lamp is there. Some motion detector devices are there. You can explore. Portable music player is there. Power meter is there. You can explore variety of siren. You can explore these variety of devices that you have in your network. Wind detector, webcam is also there. Water level monitor is there. So what I'm trying to say here is water drain. What I'm trying to say here that you can explore these variety of IoT devices and everything you see, everything that I just put and drop, it is IoT. All of these devices are IoT capable. Means they have that sensor which I was talking about. All these devices, they have that sensor that we in fact need all these devices, they have that sensor that we need for these devices to interact with the IoT ecosystem. Smart home appliances, I can say, they are there. We will use a few of them to create, in a moment, I will create some sort of smart home environment. Now, not only the smart home, we have some smart city. You go to the smart city, you can see ATM pressure monitor, you can see some battery, you can see some beacon signal, you can see some carbon monoxide, fan, vehicles. We have some cars as well, power meter. So RFID card, different types of, when we talk about it, street lamp, for example, wind detector, for example, these are different smart city appliances that you will see. Industrial appliances, if you see, you will see a few appliances that you can use in industries respectively. So, all right. And power grid, anything related to the power grid, you will be able to see here as well. So what I'm saying that in the end device tab, now in this packet tracer, they also have integrated a lot of things related to Internet of Things as well. Now, just next to that, we have a section called components. Click on that component. You click on that component, and in that component, you will see something called an MSU board, SBC board. You have these different types of board that in this packet tracer software, we have that one thing, this MSU board, or one thing that we have is that SBC board and all. So different types of controller boards, if you're talking about that, different types of controller boards, we have that here. Now you can just click on this one. If you can click on this one here, you can do some specifications, and here you can do, you see, let me just zoom in. This is how it looks like. This is some sort of control board that they have here. You can do some sort of programming. For example, you can connect it with a LED light, and you can just, you know, run this program. By default, this program is there. That program is to blink that light on and off, or on and off. You see, this is the very basic program. Otherwise, what you can do, in fact, here is that you can run that program. So other than that, what you can do here is that you can create some new programs as well. You can create some variety of new programs here as well. If you know programming, you will be able to do that from the centralized point. All right. We have some sort of other types of board as well. If you see here in the programming section, we can create different types of programs as well. You see, I can create the programs. These are some predefined templates, but if you want, you can create the programs as per your known language as well. For example, like JavaScript, Python, or Visual Basics. You see, if you select Visual and you just create it in the Visual, now here you will be able to see that program. Let me show you. Here in the program, for example, we have function, we have variables, we have logics, we have loops, we have math, text, list, dictionaries, pin access. We have pin number 0, pin number 1, 2, general input, output pins that we have, networking, TCP, UDP. So if you know at least a little bit basics of programming, you will be able to do that with the help of this device as well. So they have included those components. They have included those components that we can actually use. They have included those components that we can actually use in that IoT infrastructure. I can connect these with the wireless devices, and then I can control them from a centralized point. I'm not going to use these. I will send you a few videos, like, you know, if you want to study, if you want to know, if you want to do the programming by yourself, I can send you a few videos, and that you can refer and you can follow those videos to do IoT based on these smart boards that I just showed you. And you can do some programming in Visual Basic, Python or JavaScript. You can create your own program to do a variety of tasks. See, we can have here like, you know, different types of alarms and pins, and those things are going to be there. We have our cables as usual, the regular cables we have as usual. We have our some miscellaneous devices and the other things. So the major integration, the major thing that you have, here in this packet as a software version 7 is inclusion of that smart home, smart city, industrial, or those, you know, power grid, those devices as well. We'll see that. So instead of using Raspberry Pi in the IoT architecture, you know, for a general user, when we talk about it, for an end user, it might not be that much feasible to purchase a Raspberry Pi system, install the operating system, control it, create the program. Not that much efficient for a normal person. Anyone who is aware of that, you know, Raspberry Pi architecture, that person can create the programs and so. But for a general user, not that much useful. So what we can do is that if we want, we can have that IP-based IoT ecosystem as well. And that is what we are going to do in our lab. We can have that IoT-based ecosystem where we are going to connect these variety of devices, these variety of smart home appliances, these variety of devices from a centralized wireless network or wired network. And we will control that using our smart devices, smartphone, for example. We get easy control over everything and can be connected in that IoT environment. So we are going to use that IP-based IoT ecosystem in our example that I will take. So before going to that IoT-based ecosystem, you must understand a few components. You must understand a few components of that IoT ecosystem. There's something called a gateway. That gateway component of that IoT ecosystem, when we talk about that gateway component, it is used to take the signals. It is going to use to take the signals from the end devices and you know, give it to the IoT server that we have, that IoT home controller that we have in our network. It enables the easy management of data traffic that is flowing between the protocols and the IoT ecosystem. It also translates the network protocols and makes sure that the devices and sensors are connected properly. Gateway devices, I'm going to use a home gateway in our environment as well. It can also work to pre-process the data from the sensor and send them off to the next level if it has to configure accordingly. This gateway device you can assume as an extra layer between the IoT cloud and the end device that we have in our infrastructure. So gateway is one of the component that you will see in that IoT ecosystem. Then we have analytics. I'm not going to read all these, but when we talk about that analytics, we have to get the statistical analysis of different type of data that we are getting from the smart devices. Those smart devices that we have in our environment, we are going to use some sort of analytics software program to gather a variety of data at a centralized point. This analysis easily helps in setting future trends that have the capability to rule the market accordingly. So analytics, when we are talking about the analytics, the IoT analytics component, the component that is used for analytics in IoT, it is responsible to gather different types of data from different types of devices for future enhancement. Connectivity, how we are going to connect those sensors and devices, how the connectivity is going to be provided between the sensors that is there and to the network. So main component that complete the connectivity layer are sensor and devices. Sensors collect the information and send it to the next layer where it is processed. We have different types of, you know, sensors like proximity. We have different types of sensors for different types of operations like proximity detection, humidity, moisture level control, temperature sensor, thermostats, pressure sensor, RFID tags, different types of sensors we might have in our IoT infrastructure. How you are going to provide the connectivity, is it in wired format or it is in wireless format, that we have to define in that connectivity option. With the help of IoT ecosystem, companies are now able to collect the bulk data of the devices and applications, and they can use that data. They can actually use that data to, in fact, improve the quality, improve the user experience of the application that they have developed. There are a variety of tools that are used in purpose of data collection, what type of data can be controlled respectively. So it is also responsible for making the decisions that can easily intercept, easily change how the application is interacting with the devices, and everything that happens in that IoT cloud. Your IoT enabled device is going to send the data to the company for general reasons, and the company can use that data to analyze, to improve the user performance of the particular device. We also have the user interface for the end user. We have some sort of application, and from that application, it provides a visible and physical part that can be easily accessed by the user. It is important for the developer to create a user-friendly interface application that could be accessed without putting any extra effort in the network. User interface of the application, or the user interface that we are going to get along with the device, is the first thing that as a customer is going to notice. So user interface must not be very complex for the end user to understand, otherwise there are going to be certain issues. Of course, protocols. The web pages are now using the HTML format, cascading styles like with the CSS. So the thing is that what protocols and what standards are now being used, what standards or what protocols are going to be used to transfer the data from those sensors to the home controller, and from the home controller to the application, and so on. You have to consider that as well. There are a lot of standard protocols. But you know, IoT specifically doesn't has any standard for the same. You know, MQTT, there are a few protocols that you will study. HTTP is one of the most common protocol that we can use for the same task. But standards and protocols, they must also be defined for effective communication in that IoT field. Internet of Things database, a server where you can store variety of database, that you have. And based on that variety of database that you actually have, you can do statistical analysis of different things in your IoT ecosystem. All right. So proper database must be there for a user, from the user point of view. When we are talking about it from the user point of view, proper database must be maintained with appropriate privacy for the same. So proper database must be there where all the user database is being statistically analyzed. And then automation. Like if in automation, what happens? Like if any event is triggered, based on that event, certain things might happen. Like if you press the remote button, it must power on the AC, or it must power on some sort of motion detector. So automation is also one thing that you will see commonly in the IoT environment. So from the IoT ecosystem components point of view, we have gateway, we have some analytics engine, we have the interconnectivity, how we are going to do the interconnectivity based on wired or wireless network, the cloud, UI, protocols, database, and finally the automation. These all are the components that you will see in the IoT typical ecosystem. And the protocols that you are using, when you are talking about the protocols, the most common protocol that you will see is this, MQQT. When we talk about the MQQT, this is one of the protocol. This is one of the protocol that you will see, in this IoT. It is specifically used in that IoT section, message queuing. Message queuing telemetry transport. Yeah, message queuing telemetry transport. It is the name of the protocol, that MQTT protocol that we have here. And it is among the most prominent IT protocol that you will see. It is fast. It is very fast. It is very reliable. So it is more like one of the standard protocol that you will see. It works similar to the, for example, like WhatsApp or any sort of chat applications. This protocol actually publishes the message that can be retrieved on the other end very quickly. It is an IoT protocol. It is an IoT protocol, not a device management protocol. It allows the user, for example, to dim the light to a required value on the fly, since it is so quick for sensing and adjusting. It is not suitable for device management. It is more like used to pass the instructions from your mobile device, from your smart device to the particular and IoT based device. MQTT, this message queuing telemetry transport, it is one of the protocol that you will see in the IoT infrastructure. It is open standard protocol. So any IoT based company that creates those IoT devices, they can implement this protocol into their devices. Other than that protocol, we have some other protocols as well, like OMA lightweight protocol. It is created by Open Mobile Alliance. It is also fast, light structured, but it is session based protocol. In this, it is going to be like creating some sort of sessions between two devices before it can pass whatever type of information it has to pass. It is also not suitable for the device management. So for the device management, we have this specific protocol, Open Mobile Alliance Device Management, a device management protocol created by, again, Open Mobile Alliance for the mobile application. It is ideal for managing things that are on the move. For example, like your mobile devices, for a vehicle. It is more complex to understand that this protocol. Again, we don't have to go in detail of these. It is more complex than this protocol, but it can be used for the device management from a centralized point as well. It is used in the mobile gateways. It is used in the telematics, those type of things. This device management protocol by Open Mobile Alliance is actually used. We have user service platform. It is also a standard based protocol by Broadband Forum. So it is also, a secure protocol, more flexible protocol to manage both existing uses of the devices in the fabric. So variety of protocols, most commonly you will see that MQTT protocol, but you can also have the other protocols for different types of operations in your actually fabric. So how it all going to work is that an IoT ecosystem is going to consist of sensors or devices which talk to the cloud through some kind of connectivity. Either it could be wired or wireless. Once the data gets to the cloud, the software is going to process. The software is going to process it, and then it might decide to perform an action, such as sending an alert automatically, adjusting the sensor devices without the need of the user, and then so on. But if the user input is needed, or if the user simply wants to check in on the system, a user interface allows them to do that as well. So we can either that thing either that temperature sensor, either that event can be triggered, for doing some sort of actions automatically. Otherwise, if you talk about it, user can take the actions on their own basis as well. And most common, tell you some common devices. Next, we will see the lab, of course. We'll see some lab in the packet tracer. But before going there, these are some of the most common devices that you will see in IoT if you are specifically talking about a smart home appliance. So Google Home, voice controller, Amazon Echo second generation, Nest Cam, Mr. Coffee, Smart Mat. You see, different types of devices. These are different types of devices that they have already made for a smart home environment. All right. There are quite a lot of devices. I have this one actually. So if you want to take a look on these devices, you can just visit that website that is iotlineup.com. You can visit this website and you can see some most common home appliances, home automation devices that you will find for the same. Now let's try to do some lab. In this packet tracer environment regarding that IoT. So let me create a very basic lab. Now I can either do the connectivity using. Let me show you a very simple IoT lab. So what I'm going to take one switch. I'm going to use a server. A typical server in packet tracer. I'm not talking about the home gateway. I have used the typical server in the network, and this server can act as an IoT device registration server. All the IoT devices can register themselves here itself. We'll talk about that. And let me take a few basic IoT devices. For example, let me take a lamp and let me take any, for example, motion sensor. All right. Now, first thing first, the connectivity. I have to provide the connectivity to these devices somehow. Since we are going to use, so this is one of the smart home IoT appliance that we have at our home. This is one of the smart home appliance IoT device that we have at our home. And to connect them, at the moment, we are going to use cables. Not a good idea, of course, I know. Not a good idea because, you're not going to have a cable plugged in from your lamp to the switch. Not a good idea. That is why later on we will switch. Later on, we will switch to the wireless network. But as of now, just consider it like that. This is a very basic topology where I have one lamp and where I have one motion sensor. And that lamp and motion sensor is connected via some sort of server that we have set up here. And let's see how I can register these devices onto this registration server. Before that happens, first of all, I have to configure them with the IP address 1.1.1.1. I will configure them with the IP address 1.1.1.2. I will configure them with the IP address 1.1.1.3. All right, very basic, simple network that I have created. So in my home, you can consider it like this, that in my home, I have one server, one lamp, one motion detector. These two devices are smart home devices. These are IoT capable devices. They have that sensor that I was talking about, and they can integrate, they can interact with the server the registration server that we have here. All right. Now I can go there. I can first configure the IP address. So 1.1.1.1 IP address. Whatever IP address you want to configure, I configured the IP address as shown in the topology. 1.1.1.1. Here also on this smart lamp. On this smart lamp, you will go to the config tab. You will configure the IP. Are you going to configure the IP on the lamp by yourself? Think about it. So, but as of now, since we are doing things statically, I'm configuring that IP by myself. I went on that motion detector as well. And in that motion detector, I have just configured the IP address. IP address like 1.1.1.3 and the mask 255.255.255.0 as well. So, you know, this is what I was talking about. I'm talking about IP-based Internet of Things. I'm talking about IP-based Internet of Things where I have configured, where I have connected the devices based on the IP address. Now, once I do that, I will go there. I will go to the Services tab. And on the Services tab, you can see that IoT, Internet of Things, this server that we have here in this packet tracer software can act as the registration server for a variety of IoT devices. I have just turned on that registration server services there. That is it. Now I have my PC with me. I have my laptop with me. And I have connected that laptop in the environment as well. I have connected that laptop in the environment as well. I will configure the IP address as 1.1.1.4. That IP address I have configured there. All right. Now, first thing first, I have to configure that registration server. So what I will do to configure that registration server that I have in this packet tracer software, you will click on there. You will go to the web browser. And what is the IP address of that registration server? It is 1.1.1.1. As soon as you hit enter, it will say registration server login. I have not created any username or password. So I will say, I don't have any IOE account. So I will say sign up now. I will just say admin, you know, done. So this server that we have in our topology is now configured for, you see, it is now configured for registration server. It is configured as registration server. Now I will go there. I will go on this lamp. On this lamp, if I scroll down, if I'm on the config tab, I'm on the config tab. If I can give the name lamp. Okay. And I will scroll down. IoT server. I had to tell this lamp who is your IoT server. Who is the IoT server? I don't have a home gateway. I will show you in the next one. I don't have a home gateway as of now. Remote server. 1.1.1. What is that? 1. 1.1.1.1. What is the user ID of that home server? Remote server, admin, connect, done. Similarly, you will go on the motion sensor. You go to the config tab. At the very end, you will say remote server. You want to register yourself on the remote server, registration server. And the user ID of that registration server is admin. And the password is also admin. And just click on connect. Don't forget to change the name. What is that? Motion detector. And connect. Done. Now I have successfully entered the information about the registration server. I have successfully configured this device as the registration server. This device, they, all these devices are configured with the IP addresses, but we had to do everything manually. Cables are included. Now if I go there, you see, I can just visit our website. I can visit that application that I might have installed in my mobile device or maybe on my laptop, and I can validate that two IoT devices are registered. I can just, you know, if I, now I can from here itself, you see, if I say on, you will see that, you know, I'm sure that you can see that this lamp got powered on as well. You say off, you will see that it will off. On, you can say dim. So these are three things that you can actually do. So as soon as I'm clicking here, the information is being passed to that lamp using some sort of protocols, and that lamp is basically taking the actions based on the same. Now, if you go on your motion detector, as of now, the motion detector is you know, it is on. It is on, but it has not detected anything. So what I can do, is that I can just press the Alt key. And once you press the Alt key and you mouse over that motion detector, you will see that it will indicate that it has detected something. So see, Alt key, and as soon as I move my cursor near to it, it will detect the motion, and more like what we say, like the light will go green here. As of now, I don't see any uses of it. I will show you that. But this is one thing that I have done. You see, I can just control my light from my centralized application. I don't have to stand up from my desk to power on the light. I can just click on the on button and it can power on. This sort of thing you can actually do in that IoT environment. I will leave this thing as it is. Now, forget about it. Now, let's say, first thing first, I'm not going to have the cables. I'm not going to have that server at my home. I'm not going to have that type of wiring. This is too much complex for a user. So let me create a very basic, you know, home environment. Where is the draw button? Okay. This is our home. We have in this home, we have actually two rooms. You know, this is one of the room that I have here. And this is the other room that I have here, for example. Here at the side, I have one side unit. Okay. Now, let me have some smart home appliances. I will have my lamp here. All right. To enter these rooms, I don't have just any normal door. I have a small door. Where is that? Right here. I have one small door here, and I have one small door here. All right. Okay. In one room, I have one fan, ceiling fan. Okay. In one room, I have one ceiling fan. And in the other room, I have maybe AC. In one room, I have air conditioning. Okay. Anything else you want to have? Okay. Let's have some motion detector as well. Okay. Let me have some motion detector as well. Where is motion detector? Where is? Okay. Yeah. Okay. I have some motion. This is our balcony. Okay. So I have some motion detector installed in the balcony, and along with that motion detector, I have a webcam. I have a webcam in my room. I have placed the webcam in my room. So if any sort of motion is detected, it will tell me in my room that, okay, something was detected. We'll see that. Now, to interconnect all these, I'm not going to have wires. I'm going to have wireless structure. So what I'm going to have, I'm going to go to the wireless tab. In the wireless tab, I will take my home gateway that I was talking about. This is my home gateway device. This is the home gateway device that I was talking about. And that home gateway device typically looks like a wireless router that I might have installed somewhere in between. All right. So I have installed that home gateway device now here. First thing first, I have to connect everything. I have to connect everything to that home gateway. I have to connect everything wirelessly to that home gateway. Very easy. You click on that home gateway. You click on that home gateway device. You just go to the GUI. Config. In the config tab, you can see that wireless for that home gateway is already on. This home gateway device is already having one SSID service such identifier. You know, SSID basically Wi-Fi name as home gateway, and coverage is 250 meters, enough for our home architecture. Now, let me set a password. Let me set a password, WPA pre-shared key. The password that I'm going to have is you know, demo, for example. To connect to this home gateway, the password is demo. So now what I have done that this my home gateway, which is typically a router, from that router, I have just enabled the wireless, and the password for that wireless is demo, okay? I can have the LAN connectivity as well. I can connect it to the internet as well, so that you can control from the internet outside your home appliances as well. I'm not going to do that, but you know, I'm just telling you that we have the option to do that. All right. So what next? I can now go on these devices. This device actually has only and only LAN port. I have to install a Wi-Fi card here as well. So what I will do, I will just go to advanced tab. Once you click on advanced tab, input output configuration, you can actually replace your wired one with a W wireless one. You can have a new one as well. If you want to have wired, wireless both, so just, you know, add one more, forget about it. I have replaced my existing network adapter from wired to wireless, considering that these devices have wireless connectivity. And then I will go to the config wireless. What was the SSID? Home gateway, already configured with that. These devices are already configured with the SSID of home gateway. What was the password? The password was demo. And done. Done. It is connected. Next, I will go to that AC appliance. I will go to that air conditioning. Again, I will go to the advance. In the advance, I will go to the input output. I will replace my wired connection with the wireless. I will add wireless interface card. I will go to the wireless, and it is already configured with the SSID home gateway. I will configure the, it is more like I am connecting everything to wireless. That is it. That's what exactly I'm doing here. I'm connecting everything to the wireless. Done. Close it. Go to the whole lamp. Go to the lamp that we have here. In the lamp, I will go to the advanced tab, IO, and wireless, config, wireless, and pre-share key. What pre-share key we have is demo. Done. What else? That small door. Advance, quickly, IO, wireless, config, wireless, pre-share key, and here also, same, demo. Here also, same. So I hope you get the idea what I'm doing here. More like I'm just giving the wireless connectivity to everything that I have in my IoT environment. Okay, the wireless. The last one, the webcam. You know? Once I have done that part, done. Once I have connected everything to that wireless home gateway that we have here, now we are good. Now we are good for the next step. Now, I have to register. And one thing you notice, you click on that motion sensor, you go to the config tab, these devices, you can just click on home gateway. Just click on home gateway, they will get registered automatically. They will get registered on that home gateway automatically. We don't have to do that manually. So what you can do now, connect your smart device, connect your mobile phone. Where is your mobile phone? So connect your mobile phone, the end device. Where is that smart device? This is my mobile device. This is my mobile device that I have here. I'm going to connect that mobile device as well, just a minute, with a wireless pre-share key. That was demo, and it was HOMEGATEWAY, home gateway. So now what I'm going to do is, it is now connected as well. What I'm going to do, what is the IP address of that home gateway that we have? It is 192.168.65.1, sorry, 25.1. I will go to the web browser. I will just paste it here and go. You see, it is already configured with that home gateway configuration. Now I can just go there. What is that? It is a motion detector, home gateway. Done. I can just go there. It is what? In fact, lamp, and connect it to the home gateway. Done. It is what? Here. It is AC connected to the home gateway, and done. It is door one connected to the home gateway. It is all these devices are going to register itself on the door two home gateway. Done. Webcam. Where is that? Okay, config. Webcam, and home gateway, connect. It will automatically connect. And finally, the fan that I have, fan, home gateway, and then connect. You see that on your device, on here, you will see that you have all these motion detector, light, AC, door one, door two, webcam, fan. Everything is now connected to that application, that mobile application that you have. But what you can do here, you can just press the Alt key, and if you move, you can see the motion detector is working. Okay, you can go to the, where is webcam? You can go to the webcam. You see, if you press the Alt button, you mouse over the webcam, you might see that, okay, some sort of action is being taken. It actually shows the image here as well, but I'm not sure why it is not showing, but it shows in the image format as well. Let me just go to the real time. Okay. Now, what I want to do is that for example, I want to set the conditions. As of now, from here, what you can do, you can just, maybe power on the lamp, you can off the lamp, you can do that. If you want, you can go to the AC, you can power on the AC, power off the AC. What else? I hope you get the idea. But these things we have to do manually. What if I want to do some sort of automation? So what I can do, I can go here, And from here, I know all of my devices. What I can do, I can go to the conditions tab. I can go to this conditions. In this condition tab, I can add the condition. For example, add condition motion detector. What condition is that? If motion detector is on, motion detector on is true, means motion detector is on, then do what? Then do what action? Then do what on the webcam? Turn on the webcam as well. As soon as, what does it mean? It means that anytime, it means this condition basically means that anytime motion detector is on, webcam will power up on automatically as well. Means like now if motion detector actually detects anything on the webcam, you will be able to see the images as well. Let me see. You see, if you now mouse over that motion detector, you will see that your webcam is powered on and you are able to see that if some person is basically trespassing, that you can validate. This type of thing you can do from this centralized point. This one condition that I have set is that if the motion detector detects something on the webcam, you will be able to validate. So if you mouse over your motion detector while pressing the Alt key, you will see that on the webcam, you will see the image. Now, similar to that, what else you want to set? Let me set some other conditions as well. Other conditions like, I will go to the condition. Other condition, add. What condition? Webcam off. Otherwise, one says, if you do not set the condition that if the motion detector is off, set the webcam to off as well. Like once the motion detector has detected something, the webcam will be on permanently. So you say, if the motion detector on is false, then do one thing, webcam false as well. I set the second condition as well. So means like if, now what will happen? If you go there and if you just mouse over it, you see the webcam is on. You can go on the home, you can check the webcam. In the webcam, you can see the webcam is on. And as soon as the motion detector does not detect anything, you will see that the webcam will go off as well. You see? What else? Let me set one more condition quickly. I can go to the condition tab. I can set a new condition that if door one, if someone, I can say that if someone opens the door, open, if someone opens the door, then do one thing, AC on and again, lamp on as well. Where is lamp? Lamp status on as well. Okay, so that thing we can do, that condition we have set. What else I can set? I can say that if door one off, I can say that if someone door one is open, set to false, then do what? AC off and do what? Lamp, where is lamp? Lamp, don't turn off the lamp, dim the lamp. I can set that as well. What else? I can set that if door two is open, true, then do what? Then do one thing, a fan, where is fan? Fan status on full speed, high as well. So we can set that. We can set that condition. I don't have anything as well. So, okay. And door two off, obviously. Door two off. If you say door two status false, then do what? Fan off. You have to fan off as well. I have set. What I'm saying that you can program from here. You can program variety of things. These are only limited things. These are only few things that you can see here. You can go to the editor if you want to create if you want to create the project based on the JavaScript Visual Basics. If you know that, you can do that from here as well. But other than that, I will just set from here the conditions. Now see, let me show you. Everything is in action. Let me show you. If first of all, if motion detector detects something, then your webcam will be on. And as soon as the motion detector goes off, the webcam will go off as well. That is one condition. That these are two conditions that we set. Okay. Second, what you can do, you can install a motion sensor at your home entry point as well. So as soon as the motion detector detects that you are home, it will power on everything. It may be power on the coffee machine for you as well. Set the conditions by yourself. Do the lab by yourself. Now let's do one thing. Let's open the door number one. If you open the door number one, you will see that the lamp will power on and this AC will power on as well. So if you just go there again, press the Alt key and click on this door. So the door is open. You can see that AC is on and the lamp is on as well. If you close the door, you see the AC is off and the lamp is dim, not off. If you open the second door, click on the Alt button, press on here. You see that the fan has started. Now the fan is on. And if you close the door, you will see that the fan will turn off. These type of things. Now you could have deployed one of the motion detector on the entry point as well. And as soon as you enter, maybe the lamp will power on, maybe the coffee machine will start working. Those type of thing you can do from your in your IoT, in the Internet of Things environment. This is one lab, basic lab that you can do based on this thing. So I have given you an idea of both the things. You could do the programming as well. You can also integrate that chip that we have here. These MCU board we can integrate here. We can have these as BC board as well. I will send you the videos regarding the same if you are interested in that. But this is very basic home appliance. This is a basic, very, very basic use case of the IoT Internet of Things. We have connected everything at my home network with a centralized gateway, and everything is being done. Everything is being controlled with my mobile device. This is what we needed to discuss in the IoT section. So overall, this is the lab that you will be able to do in your IoT class. I can save it and I will definitely share this lab with you guys as well. So, and I will also give you one lab of the IoT that you might try to do by yourself. And that lab, I will also share you some links, some videos that you can refer for the same. But in the Packet Tracer 7.0 version, you have this IoT capabilities as well. So this IoT part, in brief, like this IoT part is done from my side as well. This type of lab you can do in the Packet Tracer. So if you guys have any question, you let me know in this IoT. The practical uses of the IoT in a home environment, you will see like this. Similar to that, you will see the environment of this Internet of Things on the other places as well.